The bonus round is back at GDC, and this week we're sitting down with industry veterans Jeff Gerstmann and Stephen Totilo to discuss the biggest headlines in gaming and beyond. Even though it wasn't tied to the Game Developers Conference, was the announcement of the third-generation iPad the biggest news to come out of the show? What does this device mean for the gaming industry? Plus, are the rumors true about the next generation of consoles? Find out what the industry is buzzing about. The bonus round starts right now. Hey everybody, welcome back to the bonus round from the Game Developers Conference here in San Francisco. And now we're going to get to some of the big headlines that are happening in the gaming industry with our good friend Stephen Totilo from Kotaku and Jeff Gerstmann from Giantbomb. All right guys, let's talk about the big news that happened here at GDC Week, which was the announcement of the iPad 3. No big announcements from Sony, Microsoft, Nintendo, but Apple threw down the new iPad. We have Mike Capps from Epic Games saying this thing is more powerful than a PlayStation 3 or Xbox 360, although I saw you were tweeting.
Not quite what he said. He said that it has greater screen resolution than, I guess, what the console's output right now,
right,
and that it has more memory than there. But yes, he came back at me right away, and then I just put his quote in front of him, and he's like, yes, you're right. Do we call it the iPad 3? What are we calling it?
When you order one, it just says, like, iPad third generation, which is how they handle all their other products.
So you've ordered one.
I spent a couple hours having the store error out and going like, all right, damn it. All right, fine.
But you got it. I mean, it's pretty amazing the resolution of that screen. And yeah, I think the name that they're seeing now, it's like iPhone 4S. At some point, they're just going to, I think, drop the numbers and just go up with the new phone. But from a perspective of gaming, I don't know if you guys have gone hands-on with it yet, but there's some cool games coming for it. Do you feel that iPad is going to become an even more dominant platform for gaming? I mean, are you finding that you're playing a lot of iPad games?
Yeah, I'm playing a lot of iOS games, iPad games. I think some of these things are a symptom of age. You get older, you have less time, so you're looking for games that can fit into the smaller pieces of your life. And so it isn't really a thing that's true for sort of everybody of every age. I was at a really provocative talk from Ben Cousins of NG Moco earlier at GDC, and he has a whole thing that he says the consoles are dying. They're in their arcade moment, just as the arcades went away. And he said, look, arcades had bigger screens, and they had better controls than consoles had at the time, and that wasn't good enough for them. And he was arguing that the same is going to be for consoles. The iPad may not have a controller, it may not have buttons, but he's thinking it doesn't matter, and it's going to just pass everything.
Jeff, are you you guys at Giant Bomb are the hardest core of the hardcore.
We're out there.
Do you find yourself playing a lot of iPad stuff?
I do, yeah. But I think the larger thing that's happening now is it's not just, is the iPad a great gaming machine? Like for traditional games, no, it's not really. But it's all about time, and I think you're finding that more people that would spend that time playing like a dedicated portable machine are now like on Twitter on their phone or looking at web pages and all that other stuff. So there are now so many more things competing for that kind of free time than there used to be that, iPad is a gaming machine, and does it dominate the other machines? It doesn't matter because it dominates the other machines in all these other connected ways.
You're not tweeting on your Xbox frequently?
No, never, and I downloaded the Vita app for that, and I think like everyone did, I wrote, I am typing this from my Vita, and then haven't loaded up the Twitter app on the Vita again. It's just not what I'm there to do.
Yeah.
But with the iPad and iPhone and kind of all these other devices, you've got Netflix and all this other stuff, and you're just on the go doing whatever. And I think that's, gaming as a whole has to kind of deal with that threat of all these other entertainment forms now being at your fingertips wherever you are. And that's probably the real thing that the Sony and Nintendo and all that other stuff with their handhelds have to face.
And what about the idea of asynchronous multiplayer with some games? We saw Mass Effect came out this week, and you can play the iPad game Infiltrator and, up your galactic readiness, and a lot of other games I think are talking about that idea. Is that something that's interesting to you, Stephen, the idea that these games will sort of talk to each other on iPad to the consoles?
Yeah, I mean, that was one of the things that I think was Bill Gates who was promising Xbox Live Anywhere like several years ago.
Where you'd take your Forza car, you'd design it on your phone.
Right, if Velocity Girl wasn't designing it for you.
Exactly.
And I like the idea that a game can come with me everywhere and I can do a little bit of it. You worry, though, that the games that are going to be on the other platforms are going to be the lesser games. So Mass Effect on the console or the PC is amazing, but I don't like the iPad one as much. It's just not as interesting or fun a game.
Yeah.
And so I haven't seen people come up with the add-on games or the side games that are as amazing as the main game. So right now it feels like marketing kind of piling on. Oh, maybe we could do this thing over here or that. But if they can get it right, it would be awesome.
Feel the same?
Yeah, I do. It's definitely one of those things you see kind of like, you know, you have your A tier game and then the B tier thing is kind of backing it up. You can even say like the Mass Effect multiplayer is there kind of serving that same purpose of just like, you know, trying to feed back in. And, you know, they're always afraid to jump in with both feet on that stuff, you know, and Mass Effect's a great example where it's like, it raises this number, but you don't really need it because it's actually pretty trivial to fill that stuff up just playing the single player alone.
Right.
And, I almost wish, and this is, you know, this is going to have to be the shift because the quality of these other experiences will have to get better, but I almost wish that that stuff mattered more and gave me a really good reason to want to go out and play the Mass Effect iPad game and play the multiplayer and do this other stuff.
There have been some good ones. Like, I like the data pad, the Mass Effect data pad that's supposed to be coming out.
The codec.
Like, yeah, I can read really about cool some idea. Of the lore because I don't actually want to do that when I'm at my TV playing the game. So take a piece of the game that would be bad on a television and move that out of it. I think
because those emails, you sort of sometimes scroll through them, you don't pay that much attention to them. But yeah, if you could have them on your iPad, it's a good idea. Absolutely. So iPad is out. That was sort of the big news of GDC. Let's talk about the console companies, because in the past, you know, they've been here with keynotes and big announcements, technology demos, no Nintendo, no Sony, no Microsoft. Steven, you've been on the front lines of reporting about a supposed new Microsoft console.
Taking some bullets.
Durango, right, is coming out. What's your perspective? Do you think, we haven't heard anything at GDC, do you think we're going to hear, we're obviously going to hear more about Wii U at E3.
Right.
Do you think we're going to hear anything from Microsoft or Sony?
Yeah, we've got to hear something from Microsoft. And while maybe nobody's officially talking about these consoles here, I mean, anybody you talk to, I mean, you just have a few drinks with somebody at a bar, you're going to be hearing, you know, stuff about PlayStation 4 or Durango or whatever. Yeah, we're obviously hearing more about Wii U and the new Xbox. I mean, there's a reason, I think, that we heard about a lot of Xbox games just a couple of weeks ago, or maybe it was last week, in San Francisco. They are clearing the plate so they can then sort of queue up the next console. Well, why wouldn't we?
But you gotta, you know, one thing I think people have to keep in mind is that, you know, whatever the next consoles are, they're not coming this year. And it's like, you know, E3 typically, I think, in the past couple of years has been very focused on, like, the big games for that holiday season, too.
Right.
So I think, you know, I'm sure maybe we'll be talking about new things, and even, you know, Wii U will be coming out this year. It'll be interesting to see, you know, those companies, if they do decide to talk about future consoles, how they talk about them. Remember, like, Kinect, the first year Xbox talked about it. It was in their presentation, but there was tons of other stuff,
but
too.
But what they can do is they can talk about the new Kinect that's going to be bundled with the new Xbox, and maybe not really focus on that. It's what my reporting has said so far. So I mean, I'm not a Microsoft spokesperson.
Connect 2 is coming.
Yes, bundled with the system. We've had
this comment on rumors and speculation.
I'll comment on all the rumors, all the speculation. So they could, you know, they could show something like that. It just seems like, well, they don't want to cut into their sales. They're steamrolling already with their sales throughout the fall, and they can in some way acknowledge this thing that's coming, even if it's just this other aspect of it.
Right. I think even that's too much. I think when we get to these press conferences at E3 this year, you know, Nintendo will obviously be able to focus on Wii U because that's where they're at. But these other companies are going to be kind of just staring each other down, going, you need to say anything? No, we're not going to say anything. All right, well, then we're not going to say anything. And the most you'll get is them saying at the end, like, and remember, next year we'll be back to talk about the future of Xbox.
So you're not expecting to see anything from a new Xbox at E3?
No, I don't think so.
Wow.
Well, I'm not looking for, I'm not thinking a whole console's going to show up or anything. So I'm not as far from Jeff as, you know.
They've got too many copies of Halo 4 they need
to
sell.
I think, you know, the challenge always with these guys is, you're right, it's like this race about, you know, it's an arms race. It's like, who's going to be first?
Right.
Who's going to be first to market? Sony has said publicly that they're not talking about PlayStation 4 at E3. Do you believe them?
If they were ready to talk about it, they would. Definitely do not want Microsoft to jump the gun on this stuff, because then they'll be forced to respond. They're just not in a position to do it.
And yet
they've got Vita out. They've got too much other things going on to worry about.
It was interesting that they sort of, you know, almost, you know, called the ball early, saying we're not going to be at E3.
That's them. I think that's them trying to, like, signal to Microsoft, like, hey, look.
Don't worry about
you
it.
You don't need to do it. You're selling consoles. Great. Just give us time. It's really expensive to develop this stuff, you guys. Let's just cool down. Next year.
What are you thinking, Steven? What is the latest on PlayStation 4?
Well, it's coming. It's not using the same. I know that. Exclusive.
Will there be a new Kinect sensor bundled in with the PlayStation 4? Can you talk
about
that?
No, but they're not using the cell processor. Right. That family processor is no longer using that. My sources are saying that they're using a CPU and GPU on the same chip, which is a new architecture that you can see John Carmack is actually really fired up about, and people are saying is a type of part that is actually already being made, and therefore can allow them to come out sooner than people may expect. Because I think, well, Microsoft doesn't actually really need a new console that badly, given how well they're selling. Sony could use a PS4. Yeah. They could use something that pushes other things away. So it's interesting to me that they don't want to signal something at E3, because they're kind of the ones that need to signal that there's a brighter future for their brand.
Well, but also, you know, Sony corporately, I think, is, you know, financially, I mean, they're having, you know, it's challenging to launch a new console, and it's like, you know, the investment that it takes to kind of do a whole new system. So I think they're still trying to recoup on PlayStation 3 right now.
And the Vita's not burning it up out there. I just don't see them being. I'm sure that there are people there that would desperately want to say something at E3 this year. I just don't think they're.
So, you know, we're talking all about sort of the business and technology side. I mean, creatively, when you guys talk to developers, are you hearing anything about sort of these new systems? You know, are they really going to change the game, so to speak? I mean, even Wii U. It's like, Wii U announced last year. I haven't really heard much about it. I mean, do you think we're going to get excited about the games we're going to see, or is it just going to be kind of fancier graphics and, you know, a new technology with the Wii U?
You're right. Like, people don't seem to have. I don't hear a huge amount of enthusiasm from developers or from gamers about the new consoles. I think people kind of expect, okay, it's got to happen at some point soon.
Right.
But I'm not hearing people like, oh, this is going to enable all these great new things. Now, Epic, they showed that Samaritan demo last year at E3. Right. This year, they showed it running on a single graphics card instead of three, and they're saying this is what the next gen could look like. But they're also they're not showing us, but I don't know if you guys got to look at it, but the Unreal Engine 4 demo.
Right. Here is phenomenal, but they're not showing it.
Yeah, that's all I've heard. I've heard it's the greatest thing ever, but you know, who knows? And you know, maybe once we see that, we'll be like, oh yeah, that's what next gen needs to look like, and that's going to make games even more exciting. But I don't know. I don't know what we're getting.
We're at that point in the cycle now where the PC games have finally, like, firmly leapt out ahead from a graphical perspective, and you can start to kind of map backwards and say, like, well, if they're going to launch this year, then they probably have to have made their plans at this point, and here's where PC technology was heading at this point. And, you know, it's, I think it'll be a bump up, and I'm sure that that tech demo probably looks incredible, but I think
it's like a cutscene come to life.
Yeah, people expecting like a PlayStation 1 to PlayStation 2 level of change or something like that.
Right.
I just don't think we're going to see that again. I think we're hitting that point of diminishing returns where it's going to be, you know, 1080p will be enough for a lot of
people. And that's why you wonder, you know, with the new controller with Wii U, how is that going to change the game if there's a Kinect 2?
Right.
I'm sure that will be a better frame rate, more responsive. Yeah. So, you know, maybe that will be more realistic to use for core games.
Yeah.
And then what does Sony do? I mean, interesting.
Well, the thing that comes up more when I'm talking to developers than the graphics or the tech is the marketplace. And that just keeps coming up, that people are desperate to have more sensible, I guess more Steam-like marketplaces where it's easier for publishers to set their own prices, it's easier for gamers to download stuff. And there's so much confusion about how the DRM should work for that and how you do all those things. I've started thinking about the Wii U controller less for gaming, but actually as a really good way to shop for whatever Nintendo's going to put up on their television.
That's a good point. Yeah.
And then it's actually better for me than, it's going to be better for me than like waving all around to use Kinect to shop. Oh, I want to buy that.
That's a good point.
I'm buying
that. Form the shape of the game you want to buy, and it'll just be
What's the Battlefield pose again.
Yeah. All right, well, thanks, guys. We will be following Kotaku and Giant Bomb for all the latest leading up to E3. And when we come back next week in the bonus round, we'll be talking to the guys from Valve.